share some family yoga with you. So I've got Christopher and I've got Nisa, and we're going to start by coming into our breath. So from your cross-legged seat, elongate your spine, lift through the crown. Let the shoulders melt down and away from the ears. And just begin to breathe as deeply as you can, in and out through the nose. Filling to that fullest point where the collarbones lift, and then releasing from the collarbones through the ribcage. Navel draws back towards the spine. And then relax that engagement and fill the lungs again. And as you exhale, try to push, squeeze every last bit of stale air out of your lungs. Bring your palms together at your heart center and just take a moment to set an intention for yourself for this practice today. About what you need, what perhaps brought you onto your mat other than me. And release your hands down to the floor, just under your shoulders. Walk your fingers out and away from the body, and then turn your palms outwards. And on an inhale, let your arms slowly rise. Turn the palms out, and as you exhale, let the arms circle back down. Inhale again, the palms turn out, and you lift the arms up. Bring your palms together. Bring your hands down in front of your heart. And then release your hands all the way back behind you. Lean back into your hands as you push the chest forward. Press the knees down, lift the chin, opening the throat. Keep pushing the heart forward. Give a little squeeze between those shoulder blades. And then pushing into your hands as you inhale, come back up. Bring your hands around in front of you and walk your fingers forward. Folding down over the legs, relaxing the chest and the head. And then walk both your hands over to the right. All the way over to the right. And fold down. As you inhale, lift the head and walk back to center. As you exhale, walk both your hands over to the left and gently fold. On the inhale, come back through center. One last exhale, fold to your furthest place, and then inhale, slide the hands back as you lift the upper body all the way up, and let's come to standing. So as you come to stand at the top of your mat, feet can be together, hip distance width apart, whatever you feel comfortable with. Give a little squeeze between the blades, turn your palms open and lift through the crown. On the inhale, lift the arms up and look up. Turn your palms out and swan dive all the way down. Let your forehead draw in. Now look forward as you inhale. Planting both palms, step back to the top of a push-up as you exhale. Take another deep breath in, look forward, and lower slow. Curl into your cobra. Tuck your toes, press it back to your first downward dog. And just take a moment here, maybe walk this one out. Alternating one heel at a time towards the ground. Try to keep those fingers spreading as wide as you can, and then press both heels down at the same time. Pushing the chest back. Take another deep breath in, and on your exhale, lower your knees and then tuck your toes. Inhale, lift the chin and the tailbone up. Exhale, draw the tailbone down, tuck the chin. Round out your back and inhale two more times, going through cow into cat. And just moving at the measure of your breath. Keep your fingers gripping, keep your shoulders right over your wrist. Last inhale and exhale. Once you've exhaled completely, come back to neutral. Tuck the toes, press up and back to downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale, step your right foot all the way forward. Widen your feet to a hip distance stance. Move the chest forward, the chin forward, look forward, and breathe. Take another full inhale. As you exhale, walk your hands around to the left and turn your right toes in. Turn your left toes out. Come all the way around and spin onto the ball of your right foot. And then square your hips to the back of your mat, looking back to the back of the room. Press that back leg straight as you can and take one more inhale. Come back around to the right now, all the way back to the front of your mat. Turn your right toes out. Come onto your left toes and step your left foot all the way up and fold there at the top of your mat. Take a breath. Inhale, let your hands clasp behind your back. Squeeze your shoulder blades together as you pull the shoulders away from the ears and begin to draw the arms away from your back. Try to keep some weight in your toes so it's not all back in the heels. Good. If your feet are apart, bring your feet together so your big toes touch. Let's start by bending the knees, letting the arms drop back to the back. Squeeze your knees together as you look forward, and then separate the hands and reach the arms all the way up. Look up, keeping those knees bent and the tailbone tucked. On the inhale, straighten the legs, reach up, take the back bend, and then fold and come all the way down. Look forward as you inhale, walking your hands forward away from your feet. Pushing into your right foot, and on an inhale, lift your left leg up behind you. Send the crown of the head forward. Push that left heel straight back. Take another deep breath in, and as you exhale, start to fold over that right leg, tucking the chin, drawing the forehead in, spread those left toes. Another inhale, lift the left leg a little higher, then looking down to your right foot, place your left foot next to it. Inhale, look to the front of the room, take a grip on the back of the legs, pull yourself down, breathe. As you inhale, walk the hands forward, leaning into the toes slightly. Now the left foot supports us. Inhale, right leg lifts up and back. Send the crown of your head forward, push that right heel back behind you. Take another full inhale, as you exhale, begin to walk the hands back, folding over that left leg, chin, nose, then forehead, draw in, lift that right heel up, spread those right toes. Go ahead, take one more inhale. As you exhale, look down to the left foot and place your right foot directly beside it. Big toes touch. Look forward as you inhale. Take a grip on the back of the legs. Pull yourself down as you exhale. Good. Let's bend the knees. Squeeze those legs together. Inhale, reach the arms forward and all the way up. Looking up. Point the tailbone down, draw the low belly in. Good, let's inhale, straighten the legs, reach high, fingertips touch, let your body lean to the right. Keep that chest forward, hips forward. On the inhale, come up. Exhale, lean to your left. Chest is forward, neck is long. On your next inhale, come back up. Draw the tailbone down as you look up. Lean back and hold the back bend. Push your hips forward. Looking towards the ceiling above you. Inhale, come back up slowly. Palms turn out, fold. Come all the way down. Look forward and lengthen. Plant the palms. Try to step back with the opposite foot first this time to the top of the push-up. So as you bring both feet back, pull the shoulders forward over the wrists. Now look forward as you inhale. Lower all the way down to your belly. Chin tops the feet. Now send the chin forward as you lift through the back of the head. Keep breathing deeply. Take your arms out to a T. Come up to your fingerprints. Squeeze between the blades and lift both legs off the ground. Stretch your toes back. Pull your heart forward. Take another inhale. Come up a little higher. Exhale, lower your forehead. Hands beside the chest. Press up to your knees. Widen your knees. Let your big toes touch. Sit all the way back to those heels and child's pose. Try to let your head touch the floor, and if it doesn't, use your hands or even your fists to make a little pillow for that head to rest on. Turning your right palm to face the wall behind you, allow the arm to drape across the back, towards the buttock, the hip, the inner thigh, and just breathe. Good, let's inhale that arm all the way up. Planting that hand in front of the face, pushing down, slowly unravel, take the left arm out and all the way up, and then lower that left hand down. Come back to your table position. Inhale, lift the chin and the tailbone and hold here. So as you push your chest forward, try to pull the shoulders down away from the ears. And take one more inhale, and as you exhale, begin to reverse it, tuck the tail, tuck the chin, round out your back, pressing your spine up towards the ceiling. Good, inhale, neutral table, tuck the toes. Slide the hands forward maybe an inch or two, and then press back to downward dog and stretch the body. Pressing the heels down, pushing the chest back. Reach your hands back and grab a hold of the tops of your feet. Try to bring your thighs back together now. Pushing your feet into your hands. Inhale, send the chin forward. Lift through the back of the head. See if you can pull those toes up towards the ceiling. Take one more inhale. Exhale, release. Feet down, hands come under the shoulders. Press up to the knees and take it back to child's pose again. Beside the head, straightening the arms, bring the knees in, and just sit in Vajrasana for a moment. If Vajrasana is not a comfortable seated pose, just take cross-legged. Lifting through the crown, relaxing the shoulders down. Inhale, let the arms reach up, and then start to move the heart towards the toes. Maybe you can grip the foot, maybe the ankle, maybe the calf, maybe closer to the knee, and now draw the low belly in, send your chest towards your toes, and relax your head down. To lift the chin, exhaling to reach the arms forward, and inhale, rise, palms turn up, let the arms circle down. So let's bring the left knee up and send the left leg out. Pull the right knee into the chest. Let that knee fall out to the side, pushing foot and leg together, firm it up, toes pull back. Sit tall and then inhale, reach the arms up and move your heart in the direction of your foot. Take that grip. Pushing the heel away, belly pulls in. Take your heart as far forward as you can, and then relax your head. And just breathe. Slide your hands just under your head. And then let your elbows come away from the floor and let your arms just hug the side of the head. Now use the strength of your arms and pick your head up. Try to pull your chin toward your chest without using the neck muscles at all. Turn your head to the right and turn your head to the left. Bring your head to center and gently lower it down, sliding your hands out right at the end. Walk your feet towards you. Arms are like railings right next to the body, palms pressing down. Feet are at a natural hip distance. So you want to think about two of your fists being able to fit in between your two heels. And then as the low back presses down and the neck lengthens to the ground without turning the head, inhale, lift your hips up into the ridge. So option one, hands can stay as they are. Option two, hands can walk closer together, palms stay flat. Option three would be to clasp the hands, climbing right up onto those triceps and shoulders. And if you have a wheel practice, your option four would be to take your hands to either side of your head and press up into the wheel. So your choice, your practice. Just continue to breathe. So we've all been spending a lot of time on our phones, on our computers, reading, hunched, and this is opening up the front of the body. So take one more inhale and rise onto those toes. If you're coming out of bridge, slide your arms out to a T and start to lower. If you're coming out of wheel, tuck the chin to lower down. And then let your knees very loosely come into your chest. Reach for them with your hands and just rock side to side. And as you roll back to center, go ahead and set your feet on the floor. Take your arms, bring them out to a T. Palms can be up or down, your choice. So all you're going to do is shift your hips a couple inches to the left and cross your left knee over your right knee. So if you're really flexible, maybe those left toes are sneaking around behind the right leg as well. Otherwise, you're just crossed. Turn your head now all the way to the left and take a deep breath in. Begin to release those legs over to the right. Try to keep your left shoulder heavy on the ground. Close your eyes. Take some long, deep breaths here. Last inhale. Full, complete exhale. And then inhale, let your head and your knees come up. Uncross those legs. So you can shift your hips back to the center of your mat. And now just shift your hips a couple inches to the right side. Cross right knee over left, maybe hooking the toes, maybe not. Turn your head to the right as you inhale. Relax your legs to the left as you exhale. And breathe. Keep both shoulders resting heavy down on the ground. And take one more full inhale. Exhale, let all the air go, and then inhale at your head and your legs. Slowly come back to center. Uncross the legs. Bring your hips to center. Let your knees come loosely in, reach for the knees with the hands, and just rock from side to side. Massage your back. Good, let's come back to center. Allowing the legs to extend up towards the ceiling would be option one. Arms can be down on the ground, arms can be up in the air. You can feel free at home to come over to a wall and do legs up the wall. If you have lower over the face. If the toes touch the floor, the hands can touch the floor. If the feet are floating, keep your hands on your mat. And breathe here. Two more breaths. So if your hands are on your back, release your hands to the floor. Even if your feet are floating, keep your head pressing down and start to lower your upper back. So keep your head pressing, keep your palms pressing as you lower the mid back. Keep pushing into the back of the head and those hands and let the low back settle. Good work. Both heels now push up towards the ceiling and then slowly begin to lower both your legs all the way down. Walk the feet in. Take your arms to a T, palms down this time. Let your knees come in and take a deep breath in. Let both your knees come over to the right. Turn your head to the left. Turn your palms up or down, your choice. And take three deep breaths here. Good. Press your palms to the floor and on an inhale, come back up. And then knees to the left, head to the right. Relax the feet, palms up or down. Inhale, full complete exhale, palms turning down. Let's inhale back to center, reach for the knees, squeeze them in, draw your forehead up towards the knees, wrap the arms tight, take another deep breath in, squeeze and relax, and make yourself ready for shavasana. Arms and legs coming out, palms turning up. Making any adjustments that are necessary so that your body is comfortable. And just letting gravity embrace you and pull you down. Letting go of all the effort. And just relax. As you continue with this relaxation, take as long as you need.